It has literary credentials which escape me at this time because that's the nature of how I think. I just think, badass, BA, good, BA or something. I know a lot of you know her and appreciate her as well, so please give a big round of applause to our local feature, Leisha Wharfield.
What I would like to present tonight is a poetry sequence about my hometown of Philomath, Oregon. It's got six voices, and I'd like to thank the people who are going to help me read the different parts. Scott and our very own Scott, and Jorah is going to help out, and Phil and Toby was going to help, and Damien. It looks like I'm one person short, and I don't see Toby running in here.
No,
he's not here.
He's not out front?
No.
All of us are waiting on
get
him.
That, yeah, get it up to the mic.
On speakerphone. Oh, there he is.
Oh, he's here?
Yeah.
Oh, Toby, come on.
I'm sorry.
Oh, good. All right. You missed us calling you. Before I start, I'd like to say many people who have taught me things are here tonight. But one of my very special teachers is here tonight, Jeff Harrison. And he's got fans. And I just want to say we don't thank our teachers enough. If you have a special teacher that you love and trust and respect who has taught you something that stayed with you, will you join me in a round of applause for all our teachers?
Uncle Dick.
How dare you to survive this weird volcanic landscape? It demands a blood sacrifice, like your late classmate, slumped against a dumpster behind Safeway in Corvallis under gray skies, who lunged for a fake gun and was really shot 26 times. Phil had just come along then. And folks said he was born with a tail you cut off and kept in a jar, which is why he stopped growing. I'll say it, I'm a drunk fool, right? The problem with kids don't listen or show respect. They forget everything, even that boy's name. They'd rather you kept Philip out of sight. But every pathetic bastard redneck sees his reflection eventually. They know it could be any of us, except on a clear day. Like they say, but for the grace of God.
Reunion, Seth. I didn't attend the reunion, but I heard what happened. I had my gallery open, and my red-haired wife wouldn't understand. We never met her mom in Ireland. There was a moment of silence for the five fallen classmates, two motorcycles, one fire. One who tried, the slow, one, the cop. What's his name again? I forget. Like I said, I'm not from there. But one art show lady said, I adore your mystic work.
Martha, how could I not hear about the reunion? That bitch Misty showed up at my trailer on the side of the hill, said I had to go. I had no makeup, but quick put on my shades. It was one of those two bright days. The boys yelled, let's go out and play. But I told them, shut up and stay in. Play your video game. Don't bother him. I should have had Do Not Disturb on the window aside from no solicitors and no Jehovah's. Said she was concerned about my safety. Concern yourself about your deformed kid, I said, and slammed both doors on her, even though the screen was broke, wires still hanging from the last time I locked that mean drunk bastard out.
Feral. I bounced back home after Germany with no posse, but I had my girl, mother of my two sons and one lonely daughter. I work for Luke now, just like my dad did. but not pulling green chain. I'm a choke setter, make top dollar, enough to buy all my wife's shit. She's high maintenance, that bitch. At the reunion, I snuck into the woods for a taste of Luke's good life. Later, I fell back in the grass and wondered, really? That's it?
Sophomore year. First thing that stuck out to me about Philomath is dirt. You see the Soothclaw forest, Douglas firs, dotted with barren or blooming deciduous trees. And everybody knows about Mary's Peak and Mary's River. I don't know who Mary is. But I'll tell you about the dirt. Volcano rich, everything grows in it. I was often made to eat it one way or another. Everybody does. Suppose you're in the horse pasture, a rusty truck pulls up, and you don't know it yet because you drive 2 miles, because your drive is 2 miles long. A plume rises, hoarse, shy, and run. Pretty soon, you got the grit of Philomath in your teeth. That's one way to taste it. Philomath means lover of learning, if you could believe that. The place where Oregon's finest college was erected. Weather-beaten brick set on a rise above grassy fields of clover, daffodils, wood, bohony. But this place, with its sprawling homestead, attracts tightly closed minds.
I posed in that old folder, in that old photo, next to a filthy building on the worn-out grounds of Philomath Elementary, with my hips shoved out, like I was sexy. We're all sexy at 11. Hip-hugger jeans, extra-wide cuffs, or at least we're wanted, like outlaws. Who am I kidding? I was fat. Fat like the sisters we see on clear days. Fat like burls on shore pines, Mama says. All we got is what God gives us, plus good living. Okay, I'm fat. Even made and cleaned up, I was never all that. Didn't I know when instead of Martha, they called me Larva? Larva, Larva, Larva. My family never helped. My sister Arlene picked up a piece of gum off the floor in front of an all-school assembly, then stuck it in her mouth. Everybody made fun of us and our brother Neville. Good living, Mama said. What's good about it?
I was born here. I didn't know what that meant until one night Daddy said a cow was whelping. We went together to the shed Grandpa built, with its double-wide concrete sink the tax man didn't know about. There's a tax for every sink, Daddy said. If the tax man comes around, don't let him in the house. I was to stop him at the cherry tree. But especially, Daddy said, and his eyes got mean, don't let him in the shed. So I didn't. I mean, I didn't want to let him in when he turned up, dressed like a teacher in a suit and tie. I can say that day the horses were especially shy. I couldn't lie. Something bad happened then. Something back outside the shed. That's where bad things always happened. A mama vole gave birth for one thing, and voles are vermin, Daddy said. They bring disease. Birds and bees hummed along the rafters of the bull's stable. I was playing in his lonely pen one day when a bee stung him and he charged me. That time I got away. I also let the baby voles live.
Feral. I'm the big fish who got away, took up with an older lady in a rich neighborhood. Roads were laid out crazy and made no sense. To a redneck, I'd ask, hey, mister, where's Lake Drive? Nobody answered. Growth was diversified, as the realtors say. Pruned hedges, picket fences. Folks pretended right in my face that I didn't even exist. What was I searching for there in the South Hills? If you lose your sense of direction, I learned you don't deserve it. If you belong there, among rhododendrons.
Senior year. Our wrestling coach demanded that we run cross country to increase stamina. There was this little Colin Cudlow, a pale, white fly late white, got jock strapped each fall in the tall, wet grass just north of the middle school, so intricately. elastic binding him, elbows and knee. He couldn't move. At dusk, Coach would find him, of course, trussed and shivering. He'd missed the activity bus. Every rider knew precisely where he lived and joked at why the bus missed its stop. My English parents chose Philomath for its college scholarship, dismissed any difference between me, Farrell, and his friends. I did back handsprings across the football fields. I split their heads if I raised my fists, so I made them laugh till they stood down. I was a class clown, also the class president. Each morning I announced the daily schedule. I pronounced it schedule. They always laughed. I left Philomath after I conquered it, but not before Ms. Johnson, not Mrs., taught me to throw clay on a wheel and held my trembling hands as we fashioned it.
Half the class was at his funeral. It was a day off school, so why not? He'd sometimes been a good wrestler for the team that swept every state championship. The coach said Neville added depth. He crashed through the Welcome to Philomath sign, nailed to the dead end of a Douglas fir in Mama's Civic, landed in the slough that drains the log pond, those old-growth blackberries so thick and strong, they should have caught him. We left the Church of the Christian Sons and convoyed to the cemetery, but more than half those bastards went to the auto graveyard instead to see his brains on Mama's windshield.
This is Misty. When that cow gave birth to an abomination, I remember her lowing and lowing like a crop duster spraying melatonin. Melatonin, Daddy said, saved our carrot crop from predators. Nobody saved me. I was heavy and needed maternity clothes, but couldn't shop for them because Mama kept me home. In her world, women had reasons for giving in, lustful reasons. I looked like sin. When Philip was born, nobody said a word to me.
Farrell, I drove home the long way. Roads were flooded just east of Alpine like always in spring. Crows, cows, and horses crowded on hillocks stuck in mud. Lost trout slapping weeds. One way through, they say, is to keep a steady speed. And if you keep running on the other side, you've been living good and clean. Mothers against drunk driving put Neville's face on a billboard. I topped the last rise of the highway before Philomath proper saw the sign, went up to the Church of the Christian Sons. Cars in the lot had bumper stickers that said, I found it. Later, I saw one that said, you can have it. Post-graduation. How dumb do you have to be to drive in the slough? I asked Dwight at the fishing hole. Dumb as Neville, he said. Remember the gore? Blackberries rotted in the August sun, sweetening the breeze. We didn't get a bite. High school was done. I guess that's the end of it.
As a kid, I thought everybody had a place like Mary's Peak. A quiet place with fresh air and flowers or snow. I could sit for hours, watch the river snake and dance to the coast, flow into our brilliant ocean. Philip and I went there a lot. I'd walk barefoot, cool my hot, bloated feet in creek water or in snow free of cold stares and gossip. Just us two together. Where no one could see.
Martha, I put up with my family's bullshit until I got away. My front yard is on a hill where I see the three sisters on a clear day. They're called Faith, Hope, and Charity. Mama, where are they? The sky is always gray.
I was a painter before Ms. J put her hands on mine, and I worked the mean wheel that mocked my failed attempts at form. I taught stubborn clay. I made it remember and be fired into shape without shattering. I can make a bowl or vase from this earth, now something beautiful which holds water.
What is it like to be? What is it like to be normal? I still wonder, even after months, high school reunion, where everyone smiled and chatted and drank beer and had lunch. Uncle Luke almost passed out in the punch, while Aunt Peggy disappeared with Farrell and everybody looked the other way. Perfumed fat ladies acted like somebody. Old men bagged about their homesteads. Folks talked down to me like I'm stupid because I'm small and I'm weak. No, I won't go no more, and I'd like to say, with you.